Namaskaram. I'll start with two shlokas, then we'll continue.
Repeat. Akka will say you.
I'm sure you all know it. You can but say
still you can repeat. Good.
Gajananam bhuta ganadi sevitam.
Say it. You also say it.
Gajananam bhuta ganadi sevitam.
Gajananam bhuta ganadi sevitam.
Umasutam shloka vinashakaranam. Namami Vigneshwara Pada Pankajam.
Namami Vigneshwara Pada Pankajam.
Saraswati Namastubhyam.
Saraswati Namastubhyam.
Parade Kamarupini.
Parade Kamarupini.
Vidyarambham Karishyami. Siddhir bhavatu me sada. Om shanti shanti shanti.
Om shanti shanti shanti.
Today, I think it's the starting of the Navaratri Puja also here. So it's apt that we begin your session
Navaratri
with Saraswati Shlokam, of course,
Navaratri,
Ganesha. Navaratri Natya Festival. Okay, wonderful. Great, now, okay.
Navaratri, nine days and nine nights. It is actually dedicated to the three deities. Shakti, Parvati, Lakshmi and Saraswati. Three deities, Trishakti.
Parvati,
yeah, you know, Shakti, Shakti, yes. Tari la kai kai, Shakti, panango, you all do it.
Shakti,
Parvati, ama, Parvati, Shakti, hoda da hai. Shakti, Lakshmi. And Saraswati.
Holding the veena.
Shakti is our primordial power. That is, for our existence, we need good Shakti, power. Power of not only physical power, mental power, and also spiritual power. She is the embodiment of prakriti or nature, where you learn everything from. Nature is our guru, that is real guru. We are all not gurus, we are only acharyas, we are only teachers. We just teach you what we have imbibed, but guru is somebody who is very, very superior to all the living things. That is why prakriti is the ultimate guru, or Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo, Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat, Param Brahma. All srishti, all creations happen from the Param Brahma, who is the ultimate primordial power. So 3 days is devoted to that Shakti, which gives us everything for our sustenance, our happy living. Symbolically, 3 days for Shakti and 3 days for Lakshmi. Lakshmi is the wealth. I mean, for sustenance, we need sampath, wealth. Wealth means not only money,
material.
All other kind of wealth that is surrounding us, as also Prakriti. Prakriti is divided into three categories.
Nature,
yes. So the wealth is also, wealth is of course integral part of our life and sustenance. And then comes the ultimate thing, Vidya. Vidya is the ultimate thing, that is gaining knowledge. We need knowledge of the world as well as knowledge of everything that surrounds us. Without knowledge, we can't do anything. So these three aspects of human sustenance, see, human living, is symbolically celebrated every year as nine days and nine nights. And ultimate, all conjured up on the 10th day, all the three are worshipped, and then you obtain the ultimate knowledge or wisdom. We need all that. So the compartmentalize Prakriti and wealth and knowledge. Three shaktis. They're called three shaktis. So that is why we celebrate. We have so many celebrations which has a lot of significance, very lot of knowledge in our Bharata. Our country is actually Bharata. Bharatam actually means the country that which eradicates the ignorance of the world.
Which removes
the ignorance. So this, our country, Bharatam, from time immemorial, has been a seat of learning for everybody to come and learn from here. That is what, when you take the history of the universe, you will see that Bharatam, that is the Akhanda Bharatam, this area of Southeast Asian countries, region, has contributed a lot to the development of our other nations. So people came, we have the or samskaram or lineage of rishis. Rishis are the greatest scientists, greatest intelligence who are visionaries, who were visionaries, and they have given so much of knowledge to the world through the Chaturveda, or the four Vedas. Rigvedam, Yajurvedam, Samavedam, and Atharva Vedas. These are very, very ancient texts. There is no antiquity. We cannot mark when it was created, when it was promulgated, when it was taught to the other world. So the Vedas are the compendium of everything. You can draw everything. It is called Purnam. It's a circle. Purnamida, Purnamidam, Purnat, Purnamijachaye, Purnasya, Purnamadaya, Purnamavashishyade. It's a complete book of knowledge, the four Vedas. You can draw anything. Even if a scientist is going to recreate something next generation, that also will be referred in the Vedas. That is the beauty of Vedas, the four Vedas. Everything has been enunciated, recorded in that Veda book. So many things have been lost, but still it is available for us. And so that is that four Vedas. Four Vedas have been, it's a very profound language they are written. So make it very simplified. It was then created the Natya Vedam, which is known as Panchama Vedam, fourth Veda, fifth Veda. From four Vedas, fifth Veda was created at a certain period, about 3,000 or 500 years. So that's what the history says. And that is for to make the study of four Vedas easy by watching. That is visual education. That is where the Natya Veda came. Natyakhyam panchamam vedam setihasam karomyaham bhavishyatascha lokascha sarva karmanu sadhakam. It was written those days, the Arya tongue called Sanskrita. It is not Sanskrit, it is Sanskrita. You have to pronounce it only as Sanskrita. Like Tamil, it is Tamil, not Tamil. So you should understand all that. through this. So Sanskritam language is supposed to be the most ancient, but also in the Dravidian tradition, Tamil is also a very, very ancient language, and we don't need to look to the towards the West to learn anything. Western people came to Bharatam to learn, acquire knowledge. That is the history, as we have proven, historian proves. We have a lot of evidences that even at a time, big scientists and big scholars,
intellectuals
came to Bharatam to learn more about it is actually probably, I don't know, historically, geographically, you must have learned. It was our rishis who first propagated that the world is round. Otherwise, people believed that the world was flat. That I don't know whether you have read it in geographically and historically, you know, it is our rishis who taught to the people long ago that world is a globe, is around, and it goes around sun does not move. There are so many grahas which are pulling each other. All this has been written in the Vedas. We can say, what are the colors of our grahas? It's a japa kusuma sankasam kashyapeyam mahadyutam tamorvyam sarvabhavagnam pranadosmi divyakaram. What is the color of Surya? What is the color of moon? What is the color of Chuva or Venus? And all those have been already written much more than before the Western scientists found out, started talking about it, writing about it. So we have that tradition, we have the knowledge, people came. So this Natya Vedam, which also says everything is, if you learn Natyam properly, it's a very big book of knowledge, because it's an ocean, of course. We can only learn a little bit, a drop only. In that, we can say, Natat Silpam, Natat Jnanam, Nasa Vidya, Nasa Kala, Naso Yogo, Yatat Karma, Natyasmin, Yan Nadrishyate. It is written long ago, more than 3,000 years ago. It was said, there is everything in Natya. If you learn Natya, you know history, you know geography, you know about the signs of the moons and suns and God, celestial beings, all the stars, and all that it is there. When you study that in Natya Shastra, you'll understand all these things. And that is how Natya has been a Vishwa Kavyam, educational system. Through Natya only, in those days, it was through Natya people educated the other people. Education means knowing about the world, knowing about the history, geography, even botanical things. What are the nature's bounty we have? All this been returned. That is all you can, when you read Natya Shastram, different chapters. There are about 36 chapters, and there is history of instruments, how instruments came into being, how was it made, and where is all that has been the history and the technicalities of the. The gadgets theater, apart from theater, the gadget that we use for musical instrument and all, how it came, how it was made, everything has been very threadbare mentioned in the Natya Shastra. That's why it is called the book of knowledge, Natya Shastra. It's a great book. So from that ocean, we have a small drop that we are all now practicing as in the name of Bharatanatyam or Bharatanatyam. It was one time called Bharatanatyam. Bharatanatyam means the entire country is called Bharatam, not India. You should know that. India is the name given by the Westerners. When they invaded us, we have Bharata, the kings and emperors never invaded any other countries. They all, the Westerners came to this land, invaded us and looted all our wealth of knowledge, as well as our wealth of the other gold and whatever, everything. They have looted and wealth. So we have been a very, very rich nation. It is wrong to say that Bharatam is a poor country. So it is not. It is full of knowledge. Vidya knowledge. Knowledge is the greatest wealth. And apart from that, we had the our earth, there's Himalaya, mountains, and all the other regions have full of many, many wealth, agricultural wealth, and gold wealth.
Rivers.
Everything has been very, very wealthy nation. But these invaders who came here looted everything and went and made us economically poor. But logically and educationally and scientifically, we are very, very knowledgeable, very wealthy. That's in the ancient Granthas, that is books, where they have talked about aeroplanes, missiles going to different planets. Everything has been mentioned, already mentioned, that only Westerners have taken and they have enhanced by writing and propagating it to other world. So that is how we should understand how profound our Vidya is. So this Vidya that we worship, Vidya, we are symbolically, Saraswati is a symbolical goddess who gives us, so well, we worshipped and respected everything that we touch. That is the idea. Any gadget that you use has to be from respected.
From Tattikari.
So we do puja for that. Everything has a puja. Puja means that is paying your respect because you are using that gadget and you are you, and because of that only you are able to write or do till the land, great agricultural things, and also you are moving car, everything. Everything that you touch.
Even the laptop that we are using, I think we have to use it. I mean, we have to think that it is something, you know, it's a way of passing out. Passing on knowledge. So yes. We do give respect to that also.
We do that now. Now everybody keeps the laptop and your computer in the puja room and they do worship. They really do that. So everything has to be respect for everything. No casualty. No disrespect to anything. So that is the tradition that we inherited. So respect not only your teacher, your elders, but also whatever you use, whatever you touch. And pardon, take the you do when you do parasparsham chamasvame, the namaskaram in the beginning of our natyam, we say, Bhumi Devi, please pardon us. These are all symbolically paying our respect to the nature. So it's not, sometimes people may think, oh, this is very ridiculous. This is all superstition and all that. It is not. We have to respect. So that is what these Navaratri Puja is symbolic of, that. Respecting everything that we touch, everything that we use. That is that without the help of these things, we cannot live.
Sustain.
We cannot sustain ourselves. So that must go into your head and respect anything and everything that you come across. So Saraswati Puja is a very, very important festival. And also you must have known, we have so many festivals. Those festivals are part and parcel of our life and our sustenance, our living. Because if you do puja for Vinayaka, that also there is symbolically, there's a meaning, because Gajavadanan there he removes the obstacles. When you really pray, everything comes. That's everything goes smoothly. It is irrespective of any religion. Everybody prays to the Almighty, whoever it may be. It is there is one ultimate power to whom you always think, and that is the power. So to get a power to live a happy life and knowledgeable life, you have to pray. So prayers are given to everything. Lakshmi prayer, Lakshmi puja, Varalakshmi, Vinayagar, Krishna puja, and Krishna pongal. Pongal is for our agricultural things and all that. We have
Deepavali.
And you know, at the time of this the epidemic, I've been writing an article about why we light lamps, what is the significance, why we do pujas. These are all designed by the ancient rishis for the welfare of the humanity. Because lighting the lamp, simple thing I'll tell you, lighting the lamp with the gingerly oil.
With oil.
Oil, the fumes that permeates kills the worms, the germs around. If there is any some germs, that kills. So in temples, we the light the lamps, the thousand lights and all that. And the
Ayiram velakku, they call it, no? Thousand lamps sometimes.
And big lamps are lit to expel all, to kill the germs all around. So that is why we have so many temples built around every village, so many shrines where the light is lit, and also the Karpura. From the Karpura, Karpuram is a chemical that is extracted from nature. It's not chemicals, but it's an extracted from the medicine, extracted from trees. That has medicinal values. So that medicinal value permeates in the atmosphere, and that kills. So that is why the more the temple rituals are done, epidemic and things will not come near us. So when it is reduced, everything has been reduced, these things takes up. When power, that is, so the more we had used to have yajnas and yagas, where we used to burn ghee and also medicinal values of nature, from chandanam, that is sandalwood, and so many medicinal trees and plants are there, medicated. They're all burned with those fumes gives atmosphere, clears the atmosphere. So you have to revive all that so that the epidemics will not touch us. The ancient times, we didn't have such kind of great epidemic. Only when there is such pujas are not done, then it will come. But that is why the Raja, the kings and feudals, they used to perform big yajnas and things like Utragameshti Yagam, so many ritualistic yagas,
yagas are offering.
Yeah, very big burning. Agni is the most powerful purifying factor. So that
Agni
all.
Is what is Agni? Fire. Flame. Fire.
Even in the any place of worship, whether it is a temple, a chaitram, or a church, or a mosque, wherever there is a worship, place of worship will have flames. Why all candles made of nice good oil, that is either coconut oil or other medicinal value. So when that is burnt more and more, the atmosphere gets purified. That is why the lamps are lit. And we have the tradition of lighting the lamp in the house morning as well as evening. Today's world, it is not there. But in our times and also, it's only 50 years, 60 years, we used to have all that because to ward off the evils that is coming to us. So lighting the lamp is very important. And Sangha Dhvani, Nadam. Nadam is also, it has a sound wave also expels the bad elements. So that's why Sangha Nadam is...
Sangha is conch. When you blow the conch, you know, the sound that comes from the conch is supposed to be very strong and it dispels a lot of
bad elements.
Yeah.
Bad.
And it brings in
good vibration.
Vibration, yeah.
Same way,
and
bell.
And also the bells. So
the bell reverberates.
Sound of bells.
Good sound. So, you know, Omkaram, sound is the greatest power and great thing in the world. Omkaram, everything emerges from sound. So the bell, even in church and all the place of worship have bells. The bell, good bell, sound of the good bells can reach wherever. Big bells, the area covered, the vibration covers longer. That is in such, you know, big churches have big gongs, so that on the whole area, thousands of miles away, can be heard. Now, because of the other noise pollutions, you are not able to hear the bells in the temples. So, but still, bell, good bells ring. That is
sound of bells.
The Kurve Gandharavam Tatra Deva Akwaralachanam. When the puja comes, they say, ring the bell. To bring in the good vibrations into the arena of that period. That's why we are bringing bells. So for everything, there is a significant, there is an in-depth meaning. It's not at all, you don't take it very...
Superstitions.
Yes, it's very, very depth oriented. So Natyam, coming back to Natyam, you're all practicing Natyam. Natyam has to be very seriously practiced, whether you take it as... profession or not, but that will definitely cleanse your body, mind, and psyche. So Natya has all those aspects. That's why Nritta, Nritya, and Natya. Nritta is physical cleanliness. Nritta makes your body clean and body supple and body vibration.
Pure dance. Nritta is pure dance. You know?
That's all one know. They know. That is why all the adabus you are doing, that is all that keeps your body fit if you properly practice. And then Nritya is things, thoughts, language, and good vibrant, good things you talk about. The songs that you interpret, they have good meanings. Either you are attributing it to a god,
nature,
anything. And then that brings philosophy. You a lot of nice thoughts. When you're talking about Krishna and his place and all this about his flute music, or Rama's good character, how he is obedient to his father, how he was so generous to his people, subjects, all that you learn, so that makes you think and make yourself good character.
And also, when you do, you are also educating the audience and they enjoy what you do. So there is a lot of sharing of good thoughts.
And Natya, of course, the final thing is Natya is spirituality. You by doing this, you cleanse your mind. That is what Natya means. I mean, you can do a lot of good stories.
Natakam
jiva pujyam purva katha yutam is all written long ago by rishis that I am interpreting, telling you. Pujyam purva katha, nice stories. You tell nice, good stories, not the bad stories. not like in cinemas, all the violence and the atrocious things they show. It is not. Natyatla, you have to do some all good things so that you can make the audience also feel good. There are a lot of good stories. I'll tell you a small incident in our own life. You will understand. When we performed Bharatanatyam, pure Bharatanatyam in the Middle East, some of the sheikh happened to be there. And they were used to the cinema dance and all that
Bollywood
things. And all. So that was very more entertaining, that's all. They didn't take anything back. But when we performed the classical Bharatanatyam and explained, and some of the sheikhs were very moved, and they came on the stage and said, we have seen the Indian Bollywood dance and things, but we didn't have that kind of, we entertained, but today we are walking off the theater with a peaceful mind. This is exactly how you use the word, peaceful mind, calm, and they were spiritually elevated. This is one instance. There are so many instances I can quote from our own life. One incident is when we performed in Kashi.
Kashi is Banaras.
Banaras. You must have heard of Banaras. Kashi is the
famous place for
pilgrim center.
Yeah.
For Bharatiya, it is Kashi is the most pilgrim center. Like the other Mecca and some people, it is the Vatican City and all that for Christians. Like that, Ganga, Banaras in Shiva temple, Ganga. It is on the Ganga.
It's the Ganga which is.
We perform there.
Ganges.
Couple of years ago, about 15 years ago, we erected Swami
Shantananda
Swami. He arranged the program on the ghats of Ganga.
On the water. They tied a couple of boats together to make a platform, and we performed there. In fact, when we performed, we could feel, you know, the boat
swinging,
moving.
So made a platform on Ganga, and the ghats, the steps of the Ganga where they used to do pujas, and also the same place they used to have a burial ground and all that. And it is a very huge area, very beautiful place, where thousands of people can sit. And there it became the gallery. So a lot of people came to see our program, and it was a Shivaratri, a great Shivaratri puja. And about 15 to 20,000 people were seated on the ghats, and we danced. And after everything, program over, I did Nandana Charitam, an untouchable those days, untouchable, attaining, merging with God. Shiva Chidambaram. Yes, that is the story of Nandana. When I did, and when I walked, I was walking through the ramp from water to the shore land. Some urchin came, stood very far away. He was in rags. He wasn't just an ordinary labor working in the burial ground. He was just standing, and he wanted to pay obeisance to me, to us, actually speaking. And then he said, Babu, main bahut gareeb aadmi hu. He said, I am a very poor laborer here, but today you have shown me. He said in Hindi, in ordinary Hindi, today, aaj tumne mujhe Allah ko dikha diya. Today, seeing your natyam, I have seen God, Allah. Well, he must have been also probably a Muslim guy. But even that mind, an ignorant mind, could elevate, the Natya can elevate such a soul also. That's what I'm coming to say. It was a greatest honor for us, because as an ordinary person, seeing our program.
That means he has understood
the story,
the core of the content of the story, though he may not have understood it, because it was in Tamil. The language was in Tamil. The music is completely from southern India, Carnatic music, and the Natya is Bharatanatyam. There is no way he would have followed, word to word everything. But he could understand the final substance, that it was bhakti that was predominant, and that he understood. I think that's the greatest. That should be the message that you should share with your audience.
You should elevate and entertain. Elevate the mind of the people. So bhakti rasam, you have to have, when you learn natyam, bhakti yoga Bhakti Shraddha must be there. Bhakti means whatever you do, you must love it.
With you put full, your entire heart into it and then do whatever you do.
That is the first and foremost thing is your complete dedication to the thing that you do, what you learn. It's not performance, it's not entertaining everybody, no, it's not doing, it's not Natya to use your, to project your personality. You first, the bhakti, you should project the art. The art will project you. So art is, when you are learning an art, you have to have complete discipline, devotion and dedication. So Nritta, Nritya and Natya gives the three gradations, three steps to elevate yourself. That is the idea of learning Bharatanatyam. That should be the first thing. If you can do, you can, if you do well, people will certainly appreciate. But first thing is, you have to put your whole mind into the art. For
as Master and Akka, just a question on that topic as you are talking, that dedication to the art, obviously this year has thrown a few obstacles in our way in terms of being able to attend classes and have that, you know, face-to-face interaction. How do you both feel about, especially after this year and this year's circumstances, learning online and using this online platform to learn from even international artists that perhaps normally we wouldn't have had that opportunity to do perhaps, but you know, after this year, everyone's sort of thinking, oh, maybe we can also learn dance, Bharatanatyam, via online. How do you feel about that?
One way of looking at it is, this is the best we can do right now, okay? We have to think about that aspect. But nothing like seeing, you know, one-to-one and really feeling, literally touching each other and then, you know, exchange notes that way is supreme. There's nothing that you can do about it right now. But there is a lot of, intensity right now, because I think everybody realizes that it's not easy to get opportunities like this. Right now, this is the only way you can share, you know, you can get knowledge. So everybody is trying their best to come forth, wanting to really know about things. And they are more regular, I find, because they don't have to travel also these days. So that way I found that there is a lot of
positivity.
Positivity. And there is a lot of intensity also, in a way. But then you can't, there's nothing to talk about, you know, when you really see somebody and you want to, you touch the person and you want to, you know, lift the arm, you just feel that that
is not there. The proximity of the teacher.
But I did, And especially if you are a beginner, I think it's very important to be one-on-one. But, you know, if you've already learned a little bit, then it's easier to share. Otherwise, it's a bit difficult.
But I will, to add to Shanta's perception, we have to take everything in a positive manner. That gives you a good feeling. Of course, given that the today's situation, this is the best thing that we can do, but we are doing it very judiciously. And this should not be the ultimate. We should not think that this should be the, we can carry on like this. But we have to tide over this. Definitely this, the period will get over and then come to a normalcy. Normalcy definitely will come at that time. We have to think of the advantage of being in proximity with your teacher. Whatever you learn, this is only a mechanical proximity. We are not very close. There are a lot of distractions in between. There are sometimes the technology fails you. But when you are in the class, in a very live class, you don't have that problem of technological difficulties, technological disruptions. Here it is. So we have to always think that we have to be, especially with Vidya, especially with the, when you are working, you can probably work. But when you want to learn something, it is definitely going to a Patasala school, college, and be with the teacher and clear your doubts intimately.
Yeah.
Here, it's a lot of, you are, a lot of distance is there. We know there is a lot of distance. We are not, there is a human vibration, the mental vibration that can achieve only when you are physically present, close. So that is lacking today's, in this pandemic period. But otherwise, this is only, we have to think, it is only a short period. We'll have to go through this and definitely have to go come back to. For that only, I'm telling, always pray for the good time to come. It's always, it's a circle, cycle. It's a circle. So always, sometimes it goes down and
somewhere
it comes.
Nature back. Is teaching us to be more careful.
This is also, yes, we are learning
like
a lot
lesson.
Of...
It's a lesson for you, the entire humanity going through this.
Perhaps a blessing in disguise, isn't it?
Yes, you're right. Blessing in disguise. And we should know that we are learning a lot of patience now.
Yes.
We are going fast in the world. So fast, we have no patience. But now I think this has given us a little study of patience. Yes. Sit at home and meditate and all that facilities. It has facilitated us to come to terms with their patience.
Yes.
People are patient now. They don't hurry up things. They don't run after them, so many things. So we have to sit at home and do certain things very meticulously and patiently. Even students, they also learn patience.
Yeah.
With their tolerating their amma, their parents, as well as the siblings, they learn all that.
Yeah.
So they had now they have a lot of time to interact with the family also. Otherwise, they have no time. Now, if our parents are at home, the children are at home, everybody is there living a good conversational environment at home, which is good for them. They will discipline themselves. Then, otherwise, early morning, you are pack up your food and you are going to the school and the parents are going to the work and the house is, there is no house at all. It's only in the evening by the time father and mother comes back, the children are already in the bed or the children are, they are playing with the gadgets. Now the gadgets are there. They're only, the gadgets are at home and the parents are at also home. And so at least they have the time to spend.
Yes.
So we take it in a positive way. And let us pray. Praying is the best thing. And be patient and be calm and quiet and sit sometime with whatever you are learning. Natya will definitely help you to improve your patience and meditative power. Natya gives you a lot of power. For instance, when you do want something, you have to be very, for instance, I'll tell you, I'll give, make you, hello?
Hello?
Now I'll tell you, let them all do, to make concentration, can they all see me? Yeah, all of them can see me?
Yes, they can all see you, Master. Yes.
Yes. Just stare at one point without moving your eyes. Samadrishti, we call it Samadrishti. And just look at one point and sit quiet. concentrate on that point, whichever point you are looking. I am not moving my eyes. Just stay there. And then hold like this and rotate your eyes. Slowly, no hurry. Just concentrate and improve your concentrational power by doing this. Only think about the eyes rolling, nothing else. And reverse it. And also, when you do this Anjali Hastam, look straight and then think about what you like the best. Keep a nice smiling face and then just eyebrows, just do the eyebrows like this. Up and down, up and down. Keep a smiling face. Look only on one point. Don't move your eyes. I can't see you all, but I am doing. And slowly increase the speed of the eyebrows. Okay, then just have the mudra, like hold the mudra like this, and then just do this slowly and then practice it to make speed. Then try to do this
like butterfly,
like a butterfly, and eyes following that. Only look at that. And make it speed. Okay. So practice that. So when you do eye exercise, you can do this. Both simultaneously. This should move. Follow, this should move and the eyes also must move. Two things at a time, concentrate, you can do, practice it like that. Can you see my eye? Yeah. Like that. That's how we used to have to improve our abhinaya. We used to do like that. Concentration. Then the mother, zoom. Opened, yeah. Can you see me? I can't see something. There's something wrong here.
Yes.
We can see you.
But I can't see. This, what is the zoom coming?
I don't know. We can see you, Master.
Okay. Just leave it, I think. Yeah, something is, I'm not able to see.
No, we can see
that. Oh, here. Okay. Yeah. So like that. And also just do this. And you do Tamara. The lotus, use your eyes. Just this is not enough. Off it, ma. Switch off. Okay. Do this. Like that. Slight tinge of movement and or close your eyes, and as the petals bloom, your eyes also should open, and then give that beautiful expression, smile, and also smell the flower. Not like that. It's Shiva, little bit. You need a lot of practice for that. Do that, Akka is doing.
Sarasi Jakshu. Kanne ipdi panuvinga. Ipdi aarambikkanum kandu pandrche. You have to start this way, and as you take it open out, you turn and look on either side. Okay. Jakshulu Sarasi. Ja, and here. Don't do here, then it'll be mustache. If you do, it'll become mustache. You have to do it here, right here. Till here. Te. So these are things that when you talk about listening or hearing something, keep this here. Don't do this. Do it this way. And then listen, really. What? Yeah. Yes, I can hear. Yes, the sound is nice, of course. Something like that. So then how will you show? Yeah, eyebrows.
Eyebrows.
How will you show? Eyebrow. Yeah, that's it. And then if you have decoration, all the putters around your looking at the mirror and making the tilakam, or you can even, this is also mirror. There are two ways of doing, and then of course wearing the earring and the bangles and the necklace. How will you show plaiting the hair? Yeah, turn your head a little bit. Or combing your hair if you have nice long hair.
See? You can feel that. You should feel what you feel.
Come the other side.
Opening it out. And see? Can you see my hair? These are all just part of acting. You have to really feel whenever you do expressional pieces like Shabdam. Ayer Serier, how many of you know?
I'm sorry to interrupt, yeah. Akka Masters. I apologize. We've only got 2 minutes.
You all. Nice seeing you all. You can wind up, yes.
Thank you so much. Really appreciate it. Very humbled by your presence. And even though it's virtual, it really felt like you were right here in front of us. And you've brought us together as a school as well. So really, thank you so much from the bottom of our hearts. Appreciate it.
Thank you so much, Vakshanika.
All the best. It's a good thing that we are able to, even though we can't travel there and can see you, it's very close. I think very clear. Thank you, ma'am. All the best to you.
Thank you so much, Vakshanika. Thank you. Thanks.
Bye.